Hello, everyone. I'm John. It's 2:03 a.m. and I'm alone here in the hotel. I'm going to do something, well, that I think's a little scary. I mean, scary for me. You guys are probably going to be fine. I mean, probably be fine. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I am going to tell you a story. But the way I'm going to tell it, it's going to be completely improvised. I'm just going to say the first thing that comes into my head, and then I'm going to keep talking until enough time has passed. Specifically, I'm going to try and talk until 2:33 a.m., 1/2 hour. I don't have a writing prompt, and I don't have anything prepared in advance. I'm just going to speak extemporaneously, say what I'm going to say, and hope that, you know, the inspiration sticks with me. This is likely going to be very awkward, very weird, very fast. So, here we go. Once upon a time, there was a terrible storm. Yes, a dark and stormy night. No, it was in the middle of the day, but it was so dark it looked like night. And sheltering from the storm were two children, Mary and Sebastian. Mary and Sebastian, two children sheltering from the storm. Where were their parents during all this? I guess they were at work. Yes, Mary and Sebastian's parents worked all day in the, the meatpacking plant. Specifically, they worked on the assembly line with all the chicken getting packaged into those little plastic and styrofoam containers that you buy at the grocery store. And, you know, chicken packing is a very dangerous and tedious job. You know, you come home smelling of chicken all day and... there's a lot of potential for infection and cutting your hands and the chicken packing machines, and the quotas are very high, unreasonably so, from what I understand, given technological advances and the economy. Chicken packing recently has become a much more streamlined and labor intensive than in previous decades. So, you know, Mary and Sebastian didn't see a lot of their parents because they worked very hard for very poor wages. But I guess maybe Mary and Sebastian's parents met at the chicken packing plant. Perhaps, one day over their inadequate breaks, they were both headed towards the bathroom at the same time, and their eyes met and said, "You know, outside of your smock, I bet you'd be very attractive." And that wasn't taken as an insult, but actually quite a romantic thing to say. And then, 15 years later, we come to the night of the storm. Mary is the older child. She's 15, and Sebastian, he is 13. Their parents have been together for 14 and a half years, and their marriage is still as strong as ever, although, you know, money concerns make things a little bit difficult for them, but they're a strong partnership, so I think they're going to make it. But, this story isn't about them. Although the cruel factory owner who keeps the chicken packing plant open and operating during the storm of the century may be an interesting character, but, you know, I'm no Charles Dickens. So, the children, the reason they're alone is because they're a little old for a babysitter. They can take care of themselves. You know, Mr. and Mrs. Mary and Sebastian's parents are not neglectful. They're not bad parents. They work too much, and perhaps the family's never been especially close as a result of that. But you know, times are tough. They've got a lot of debt. The time Mary fell off the jungle gym, broke her coccyx. That was a lot of medical bills. They're still paying those off, 10 years later. But, there's a lot of love, even if they don't always express it in a way that, modern urban liberals would approve of. Mary and Sebastian are in, the storm cellar. I guess they live somewhere where there's tornadoes, Kansas, perhaps. Kansas, but meanwhile, back at the chicken packing plant, this tornado has been making things pretty difficult. Feathers everywhere. No, actually, I don't know about chicken packing plants, so whether the birds are defeathered by the time that they reach that point in the production line. But, assuming that they aren't, it's chaos. And old Mr. Chickenson, he's like, I don't care if there's a tornado outside. You are going to pack these chickens, or I will find some people who will. And, Mary's and Sebastian's mother's like, oh, please, Mr. Chickenson, no. I need this job. Mary just got an A on her physics exam, and she, has a bright future ahead of her as an engineer. But unfortunately, college is so expensive these days that I need this job. And it's like, I don't care whether your Mary is the next Albert Einstein. Get those chickens on the assembly line right away. But, that's not really relevant to the story. And it's not funny. I mean, a lot of people are in that situation with the economic hardship. So to have them go through such humiliation at the hands of a cruel chicken meister is not at all amusing. But, okay, so Mary and Sebastian are cowering in this storm cellar. School has been canceled. Everything in town is closed except the chicken packing plant. I'm sorry, I just can't get this conceit of the maniacal chicken packer standing up on the roof of the chicken plant, packing plant, defying the heavens, saying, we will get those chickens packed out in time. I dare you to strike this down. And of course, the tornado is too intimidated. It's gone towards the residential part of town.